The primary mission tonight is to investigate what happens when you're running the engines lean a peak. I've been taught to run slightly rich a peak, and it sounds like that's probably the worst thing to do for an airplane, especially if you're running 60 degrees rich a peak. I thought also, though, I'd never really introduced the inside of the aircraft here, so I thought I would do that. Seen its underbelly, and shot a couple of videos so far from inside the cockpit, but let's actually look and see what we got here. So it's off right now. You won't be able to see that much, but here's the inside. This is what the instrument panel looks like. I can point out a couple of things. So this is actually got an updated instrument panel. You got your standard six-pack here, airspeed indicator, artificial horizon, attitude indicator, altimeter. Wow, look at that. Field elevation is, we got really high pressure today. The field elevation is about 950 here. And 30.2, okay. Vertical speed indicator, that right there is an HSI. Kind of glad I got that one. That's wraps up a directional gyro, and the CDI is all into one instrument, so it's kind of nice. And that's my it's my primary control for, at least for my heading sets for my autopilot. Turn coordinator, got the kind of rather strange flap indicator over there. And then kind of on the bottom side there, there's my old Century 2000 autopilot. Coming back over here, it's a twin, so we got a lot of engine gauges. This entire central panel here is dedicated to the engine gauges. So I got my EGT and cylinder, and my exhaust gas temperature and cylinder head temperature monitors. Shows the temperatures by cylinder, by engine, up at the top there. Manifold pressure, right? So that's a constant speed prop. Power is proportional to the manifold pressure and RPM in some complicated way. RPM gauge is next, and then I have my dual fuel flow indicators. So it tells me, actually that's my primary device I use for monitoring engine, how much fuel I have left in the engine. I don't trust my fuel gauges worth anything. And then down on the bottom there, I got the oil temperature and pressure. Over here, I've got the GNS 530, Garmin GNS 530. It is with a WAS, so I can do LPV approaches in this. It's quite nice. And then I got my I got two radios in there, one COM1 and NAV1 up on the 530. And then I've got a second COM down there on this ICOM module down there. It's my COM2. This is the Garmin transponder GTX 330. It could be ADS-B. I think it needs a firmware upgrade, or I can't remember. There's something, I don't actually have ADS-B out here. I got an ADS-B tail beacon or nav beacon on the side. I can show you that. Cowl flaps, I got the flap levers down there, and then all of the switches and selectors for lights and fuel pumps and beacons and the mags over here and the master. Boy, I just realized I gotta get going. It's gonna be sun down here, so we'll do a quick one here. 120 gallons fuel capacity on this airplane. I got the main fuel there. Aux tanks right there. And then I got the wing tank, tip tanks right there. Same thing on the other side, main, aux, and tip tank. And this right here is the ADS-B out. Gotta have my nav lights on every time. There's no sound on this one, but I can explain what's going on. So I'm going through my checklist and gonna start my engines. So I found the most effective way to start the engines is to basically just flood them full of gas and go through what's like the hot start engine start procedure. It's pretty simple. You basically turn on the fuel pumps for a bit, maybe 3-5 seconds with the throttles and the mixtures wide open. There I am, pull the throttles mixtures back,
I thought for a second I'd maybe push the throttles back to a quarter open, but no, I'm just gonna go full open. Start the right engine. Right engine usually starts right up. A little bit of press the digitation to get that mixture up, and then the throttle pulled back within a few seconds, but you get surprisingly good at it. And then I'm gonna probably start the left engine here pretty soon. Sometimes it hesitates, but in this time it just shot right up. I kind of fumbled the start procedure a little bit though.
Started recording. I always start recording way too late. Started right after engine. Engine start up at this point. That's good. And yeah, look at that. Those engines are creeping up. That looks good. Back to our checklist. Flaps are set for short field takeoff. Breakers have been behaving themselves recently, that's good. Gear's looking good. Radio and avionics. Don't have that much to do here now, but I've got 122.0 field CTEF, and then I've got Madison. Got Madison West departure tuned in on the standby. No weather to pick up. I will set my altimeter to the field elevation of 954 feet. Let's taxi. Let us tell everyone we're taxiing first, however. Wanakee traffic, Twin Comanche, 7828 Yankee, back taxi, runway 27 Wanakee. Nose, brakes, engine instruments. Looking pretty good. Start off with our feather check. Left engine good. Right engine good. Up to 2,200 RPMs. Throttles back to 1,000 RPM. Tram.
Mather traffic. 1 minute, jumpers over the Mather airport.
Flaps are set. Parking brake is off. Cowl flaps are open. Mixture rich props. Full forward. Lights, I got just about everything on that I can get on. Let's put those fuel pumps on, pitot heat, no, flaps, been set. All right, we will announce our intentions and we are ready to go. Wanakee traffic, Twin Comanche 7828 Yankee is departing runway 27, departing traffic to the west, Wanakee. Amazing. It's only been a week since I've flown this thing, and it feels like I haven't been in it forever. Line up and depart. I don't see... Oh, I got some traffic over at Maury. Looks like it should be a pretty quiet night tonight. Oh, and look at that sunset. Beautiful. Bring our flaps up. Gears up, flaps up. So for our first couple of, all right, let's close our cowl flaps. Our first couple of investigations, I'm gonna pull our power back. I'll go do a 19 and 23. That's the so-called, what is that called? The training cruise, some people call it. All right, and we'll, initially gonna back, so my PEGT is, I don't know, maybe 1430, 1440 on the hottest cylinder.
Time for forward to Quebec. You just start to descend, got a Mooney about 10 miles behind you, gonna overrun you, got 40 knots on you.
My cylinder head temperatures are nice and cool.
542 Quebec, no preferences as long as you're below 6,000.
I don't know, what should I do? Should I like lean them both at once or? Let's do a clearing turns. Clearing turn to the left, clearing turn to the right. Okay, I'm not seeing anybody. Go on up to the Wisconsin River and then we'll head on down. Alright, let's I definitely noticed a loss of power there. I think I still have power though, and my, I mean, is that right? My fuel flow is 3.7 gallons an hour? It's a little bit clearer, but boy, those engines really seem like the... Alright, there's a... Alright, they're definitely running rough now. But it's getting
clean. 2 Julie Delta, does that maintain 5,000?
I'm ready to go back
home. 2 Julie Delta.
Wanakee traffic, Twin Comanche 7828 Yankee is turning base, runway 27 Wanakee. 105. More flaps, go all the way in.